If you're considering selling your home in Middle Tennessee and you're talking to real estate agents, these are the three questions you should ask those real estate agents before you pick one. My name is Jason Gruner. I am a real estate agent here in Middle Tennessee with Coldwell Banker Barnes, and we're going to go through the three questions you should ask your real estate agent that are the most important before that you need to know the answers to before you hire an agent. The first question, and this is a tough one for a lot of agents, is how much will you spend in advertising to get the maximum amount of exposure for my home? Everybody knows in Nashville and Middle Tennessee and really the entire Southeast, the market is really, really strong for sellers right now. So you don't need to do a whole lot of marketing and advertising to get a home sold. But if you want to sell it for absolute top dollar and give yourself the chance of, I mean, it's really once in a lifetime what we're going through now, how strong the market is. And the most important thing you can do is make sure the most number of buyers can see this house so they can potentially be aware of it and then hopefully fall in love with it with some of the marketing, come out and see it, and then bid on it against other folks to help drive up that price. So if you're not asking, if your agent can't answer the question, how much will you spend on marketing and advertising to get my home sold, and ask them how they'll spend it. I mean, we list homes all the time in Middle Tennessee. Typically, we're in South Nashville, so we're listing stuff right around $1 million and up. We spend $5,000 to $10,000 in direct advertising to make sure these homes get the exposure they need, to make sure there's no one out there who can say, oh man, I wish I would have known about that home. We never saw it. It went for sale on Friday and they took an offer the next day and we never even knew it existed. But when we take a home for sale, we take a 7 to 10 day window and we are extremely aggressive with both our digital and our offline marketing to make sure anybody who's currently in the market for the home, and a lot of folks who aren't, but we pique their curiosity with some of the marketing, they kind of get, they're curious about it and they're like, oh, that might work. Let me get some more details on that. They end up coming to a showing and absolutely falling in love with it. Unplanned, they weren't checking Zillow every 15 minutes. They didn't have a buyer's agent who was sending them listings every day, but they fall in love with it because they saw an ad on Instagram or Facebook, or they watched a YouTube video, or one of their neighbors got a postcard like this. Because anytime we take a listing, we send a postcard like this to the neighbors. We know the neighbors are probably not gonna move four doors down the street, but this one was in Green Hills. We sent 3,000 of these out to everybody in Green Hills. We had 10 people come to showings who said, specifically, my neighbors got a postcard. They heard about this place. We weren't really looking, but we want to be in their neighborhood. So they told us about this coming soon listing, and that's why we're here looking at this. It absolutely works. It's extremely effective. The other things we do is we put it, like, so we spend marketing dollars where people spend their time, and people are on their phones scrolling. It's where a lot of people spend a lot of time each day. So we put ads for our homes on Instagram, Facebook, and on YouTube. These are extremely effective mediums to get these homes in front of folks. I know there's a lot of people out there who aren't looking for homes, but they follow Luxury Nashville and a couple other high-end agents just to kind of scroll through and look at homes when they pop up. And when they see a really pretty one, they click on it and they kind of scroll through. And so when we market one like that and we pay advertising dollars, not just like posting it on our Instagram and hope someone finds it, we say show this to a specific group of people who are actively in the real estate market in Middle Tennessee. They see those, they click on them, and they give us their information for more details on the property. We start that process of getting them excited about coming to see the home. So first question, I know it's kind of a long answer, but the first question you should absolutely ask your potential real estate agent is how much will you spend on marketing and advertising to get my home sold? Number two is you need to ask them, what's the story you're going to tell about my home? And that really means two things. One, how are you going to present this home to folks? This is a 5-bedroom, 3-bath. It's on a cul-de-sac. It's really nice. Or are you going to talk about how the back porch is where we used to drink coffee in the mornings and love to watch the sunrise over that tree over there? I can't tell you how many times I've sat down with potential sellers that were thinking about working with me and asked them, you know, where did you guys create memories in this home? Where are some special spots in this home that I might not know about? To a T, there's always 3 or 4 spots that I never would have noticed, and most buyers wouldn't notice. But when they give me that information, that's something I sock away and obviously make notes on, because I tend to forget some stuff, but I make notes on that. So every time I'm showing that house, I make sure to point out, oh, and over there is where they'd have coffee in the morning. And over there is, he liked to read books underneath that tree. And they had a little Adirondack chair set up back there. It's really kind of a cool spot. And it's just those little moments that can help a potential buyer go from liking a property to falling in love with the property, which is really the goal with all the marketing and all the sales stuff that we're going to do, to get a couple different groups to fall in love with your property and hopefully drive up that price and get you absolute top dollar in terms of the strongest offer. The other thing we do is you have to position the home in a way so the buyer feels like they can win. Every seller says, I want top dollar. I'm not taking anything less. And all that does is it makes the buyer feel like I'm going to have to overpay. And it's not going to feel like a win for them. So you're gonna have a lot of buyers that just don't wanna do that. We see it all the time. When we work with buyer clients and we go look at one on a Friday and they're like, you can present an offer, but we're not even looking at anything till Sunday at 8 o'clock. It gives them it's a couple of downsides to that because they know, okay, this is probably gonna be multiple offer. I'm competing with 10 other people. And now I've got 48 hours to talk myself out of it. It's just really not a healthy environment to put a buyer in to get excited about purchasing a home. Even if you win the bidding contest on Sunday night, you still feel like, well, I overpaid for everybody else. You're excited about the house, but in the back of their mind, they're not feeling like they won anything. So what we do, we always try to talk to the sellers and hear the story about why they're selling the home. We're moving to Florida. We found our dream home up in Hendersonville, whatever the case may be. And we take the time to convey that story to potential buyers. Hey, these folks are moving to Florida. They've got a home down there. They're just ready to get a deal done. Because what that does is it implants in the buyer's mind that like, oh, there might be an opportunity here. Now we know in today's market, it's going to be multiple offer and it's probably going to go for more than list price. But when you implant that in their mind where the buyer thinks, oh, I can get a good deal on this, that does a couple things. That sticks in their mind. It also gives them a story to tell their friends, their family, their uncle from Nevada who's a realtor who they're going to see at Thanksgiving and say, hey, we bought a house. And it's like, well, how'd it go? What'd you pay? And, you know, so it's like, hey, you know, it was listed at $1 million. We ended up paying $1.2 million. Oh, you're crazy. You shouldn't pay over ask price. That's crazy. Versus, you know, there's multiple offers and Nashville's a really hot market. You feel bad telling that story to someone else. No one thinks like, oh, they won. They beat out all the other people by paying more. They're smart. No one feels that way. But when they can tell the story of, hey, you know, we got an early on this listing. Like one of our friends got a coming soon postcard and somehow we were one of the first people to see it. And the couple, they were moving to Florida, so they had to sell it. And they wanted a quick contract. We put it in. We came to terms and we bought it for 1.2. The number is the exact same, but the story in the buyer's mind and the story they get to tell their friends and family and their uncle who's a realtor in Nevada makes them feel good. And that matters. And if you position the home in that way, after they've fallen in love with it, it just gets them through that whole cycle of thinking like, I'm gonna have to overpay. It's gonna be competitive. We love the home, we want it, but man, we just want to be smart. If you can just give them that story, which is a true story, and present it in a way that allows that buyer to be a winner in the whole transaction, it makes a huge difference. I can't tell you time and time again, when I've sold a house to someone, 3, 4, 5 years later, they call me and they're like, hey, we're ready to sell again. I still remember we got such a good deal on this house. Those folks are moving to Florida. I can't thank you enough for helping us get that. And I didn't represent them. I was a seller's agent and they were thanking me for helping them get the property, which is a fun position to come from for a transaction. So the number two is the question that realtor really needs to be able to answer is how are you going to tell the story of my home and how are you going to position it so the buyer can feel like they're going to win? And number three, and this one continues to blow me away that the answer isn't completely obvious for everybody, is will you be present at all the showings of my home? I can't tell you how much it blows me away when I hear that people are taking listings for $1 million, $1.5 million, $2 million, and the listing agent won't show up for showings. It's crazy to me, especially in this market, because everything typically transacts over a weekend, so it's a day or two. And folks are going to be trusting me or another real estate agent with the most expensive asset they own, most likely, to sell it. And they're going to pay tens of thousands of dollars for me to do that. And so and I've already spent a bunch of money on marketing to make sure people get to the house. I'm showing up for every single showing. Anybody who wants to see that house, I will be there during that showing to help their agent tell the story, point out the high points of them, tell them about the story of the deal structure to set up a scenario where they feel like they can win, and it absolutely makes a difference. It also gets you on the same page as the buyer's agent. It blows me away when a buyer's agent will write an offer sight unseen, or during the showing they want to run it. And I mean, if someone is really adamant about it, I'll stay out of their way. They present an offer and there's no relationship between me and the agent. So I mean, when that happens, I'm not going to go to bat for those folks. I'll call and ask if they want to raise. But I mean, it's not the best way to engage with that buyer's agent. And we're all working towards the same thing, which is to get a deal done for where both clients are happy. So when I'm present at a showing, it makes a world of difference because it allows me to tell the story of that home. And it really gives a chance to help that client go from liking the home to loving that home. And it presents it in a way where they can still win in the transaction as a buyer, even though it's a seller's market and everybody knows it. So those are the three questions you should ask any agent you're considering listing your home with. Number one, how much will you spend out of your pocket on marketing and advertising to get my home the maximum exposure? I'm not talking you pay $300 for photos and $200 for a video. That doesn't count. How much will you spend on advertising to make sure everyone sees my home? Number two, what's the story you're going to tell about my home? If they don't have a good answer for that, you need to start questioning a lot of things. Because if the agent that can position the house correctly wins every single time. It's an extremely valuable skill. It's not hard to do if you take the time on the front end to learn about the house and learn that story that's going to make sense to the buyer and allow them to win. And number three, will you show up for every showing on my home? Again, that one blows me away. Talked to a client who had a home on the market for 3 months. It had 73 showings. I was like, well, how's the buyer's feedback? What's your agent telling you? He's like, well, he forwards me the feedback from the MLS. I was like, what? Well, he's there at the showings, right? No, he hadn't been to one out of 73 for a house that hasn't sold. It's amazing to me. But that's the market we're in right now. You don't have to show up to get it sold. But if you want it to sell for top dollar, you need your agent present at the showings. Again, my name's Jason Gruner. I'm right here in Nashville in Middle Tennessee. If you have a home and you're thinking about putting on the market, you'd like to see a full marketing and advertising plan, one of the ones we've done, not like project, these are ones we've actually done. One was actually for this house in Green Hills. We've got three of them below. There's a link where you can go sign up and we'll send it to you. We'll show you everything, where we spent every single dollar, how many leads came in, how many showings showed up, how many offers we got, and kind of how we structured that. It's a real good case study in how to market a home correctly. If your goal is to sell it for absolute top dollar. So I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. And if you want to get in touch, if you have any questions about real estate, or you'd like to take the next step and put your home on the market and work with an agent who will do those three things, spend money on advertising, tell the story of your home and position it in a way that a buyer feels like they can win, and show up for every showing, I'd love that opportunity to talk to you about it. All my contact info is below. I'm pretty easy to get a hold of, and I look forward to talking to you soon.